Thank you, Or. And while I present Hanan, could you come and load your presentation? We have a slight change in order. However, we now have the first speaker on stage, and this is Hanan Lachover, co-founder and CEO of Five Min, that was acquired by AOL, talking about mergers and consolidation, and currently the general manager of AOL Israel. Also president, vice president of video technologies at AOL. Now, 5 Min is a fascinating story because it started with providing 5 minutes, short videos of how to do this, that, and the other. And eventually they realized that there was a very interesting business model behind this, which was not at all obvious. And Hanan will talk about this as well as other things. Hanan provides years of industry experience in technology and leadership, having previously co-founded, as I said, 5 Min Media. CTO of 5 Min Media, Hanan led all software and development efforts at the company from its inception. Prior to 5 Min, Hanan led a software development team at 888 Holdings, and before that led a team of over 30 employees at Internet Gold. Hanan.
Thank you, Ayala. And again, apologies for being late and mixing all the order of the presentations. So before I'll talk about television of tomorrow, which is the topic of the presentation, first I'll say that I'm not a futuristic, and I do not know what will be the future of TV. And I'm going to look at it from our side, 5 Min, AOL Video, from the side of where the money is, meaning looking at it from the side of the ads that monetizing this industry. So before that, I'll just say, because there are a lot of entrepreneurs in the crowd, so I'll just say that this is a trip that for me and my partners run, who is leading now globally video in AOL and Tal, is a trip of over 7 years now, that started, at a little garage in Or Yehuda with three people, and it's very exciting, and maybe I'll try to put it in the presentation, though this is not the topic. This works? No? Yes. Okay, it's important for me to say that in order to talk about the future of TV, we need to understand what is TV, and there's a lot of debates around it. Is TV, maybe TV is only a screen, but it is very known that the big screen is very important and centric in our lives, and I'm sure that it will continue to be there. The one thing that is also certain is that TVs are becoming smarter. I think that technology-wise, there is still something new, very innovative, that hasn't come yet for TVs. I don't know who will do it or when will it do it, but I think it'll happen in the next 2 years. Maybe it'll be Apple with Apple TV, maybe it'll be someone else. But even today, with the smart TVs that we have in the market from Samsung, Sharp, LG, etc., there are expected to be, in 2015, more than 500 million smart devices operated by gestures and voice, etc. The way we see it, and maybe I'm advancing to the future, and I'll talk about it at the end of the presentation as well, there is no such thing as TV and online video, or TV and video and digital, like many people are trying to say. We're saying that it's all one thing, but the parts of the industry are not ready for it, especially the advertisers. And I would quote Ron on this. He's telling usually a story about his 3-year-old daughter that woke him up at 5 a.m. saying, "Daddy, wake up," and he was tired because he went drinking the other night before. So he opens the TV, he didn't find the iPad or something, and he put in PBS or a kid's channel, and there's Curious George, and he's telling her, "Watch it, I'm with the blanket, wake me up when it's over." And after 5 minutes, it's over, and the rollers come up, and she wakes him up, And she's not angry or something. She's just saying, do it again. Put it from the start. I want to watch it. And he's saying, like, I can't. It's PBS. This is the broadcast. And it's from 5:15 to 6. And now it's 6. And it's over. And she gets frustrated from this because she doesn't get it. For her, it seems impossible that you can't go back to the start of the series. And I think that for the digital native generation, it's all one thing. But on the other side, as I said, there are a lot of dots to connect, and we find that AOL have a big role in it. And I'll try talking to it. I'm going to skip this. So at the beginning of TV, there was linear viewing, and TV used to be TV. There are a few channels, maybe later on thousands of channels, but still channels where you watch whatever is being given to you. And in the past few years, we're seeing that non-linear video viewing is exceeding regular TV, linear TV, meaning if we combine mobile, tablet, desktops and connected TVs together, the time that we spent, the hours we spent watching monthly on video, we are already passing the time that we spend on TV. And again, I'm saying, for me, we need to connect all of them together. It's not that it's that different. And I'm moving to the ad space, it seems that remembering the ad is lowest on TV. It's the 27%. It's PC, connected devices, tablets and mobiles, and only the last one is TV. So what we're saying, and again, we need to understand, if we're talking about the money involved in advertising, there are like, I think, $70 billion yearly spent on ads on TV, and maybe four on what some call the online video space. This is one of the reasons that we believe that more and more money need to move from one side to another, or maybe connecting them and looking them at one. Also, another data that I want to show is that when you try to reach more and more people, as much as you go higher on the percentage of from the population that you want to reach, it becomes higher and more expensive to buy it, meaning the last 0.5% costs, I know, what's the number here? $4.4 million to do that, or something like this. But what I'm saying is, as much as you want more, you don't need to pay it linearly, you're paying exponential. And this is a thing that in the internet looks differently. And what we're saying is that the fragmentation of the internet is an opportunity for limited buying, for limited leverage, options and formats, meaning we can achieve more of what you need, more of the audience that you need without getting the 90%, because you don't need, in order to sell a watch, to reach 90% of the population. You need to reach the ones that you think that will buy this watch. And these are things that in linear TV are harder to achieve. So I'm going to talk about early missteps regarding video. When video hit the market, it was and there was supposed to be here some videos of cats running or somewhere there. This is a lot of the content that was uploaded. If we're talking about YouTube, which I have, you know, huge amount of respect, and they're amazing. They did something to kickstart this era in a beautiful way, but they are a technology platform which allows every video to come in, and there are tons of views that were generated for so-called cat videos or teenagers jumping on a bed or these kinds. And we believe that the true potential of digital and also regular TV in the future is programming and pipes, and this is what we've created along the way with 5min, then 5min Media, AOL Video, and now the AOL On Network. And I'm gonna talk a bit about it so you can see what we did. But at the end of the day, we started, as Ayala said, as a destination site for aggregating how-to content. This was the first initiative, and it went pretty well, and we reached nice traffic. But then we understood that there's like a glass ceiling that we cannot break if we continue in the same way. And as Ofer said
before,
this is me, Ofer, right? So Ofer is good. You need to spin and spin until you find your way in the area. And in this year that we did this, we learned that in order to break this glass ceiling, we need to create a platform that distributes those videos that we have and maybe other videos. And we became a platform that bridges between content owners, site publishers, and advertisers. And we definitely broke that ceiling, and I think we'll show some. So programming and pipes, meaning the pipes are the pipes of distribution, meaning we can reach a lot of audience. And the programming is the ability to give the viewer the ability to see what he wants. So he can choose, but not a fully lean forward experience, rather also a programmatic one like in the linear TV. We've become the largest premium video platform. We're talking here about monthly content streams. This data is from September. The data is already bigger. If we're looking at other premium, you can see that by far we're passing them. Of course, YouTube is huge and will continue to be huge, but it's definitely not a premium video library. Maybe it has some premium in it, but it's different. So this is one look at this. And the other one is, if I'm looking at other portals, AOL has a big portal, AOL.com, like MSN, Yahoo, and looking about the reach we have to unique visitors, which is an input, a piece of data which is very important for the advertisers. We are very much near YouTube and a lot above the other portals. And if I'm looking at it from an episodic side of the picture, we're by far the biggest if we're looking at other TV broadcasters or online players like Hulu. For now, we are mainly, if I'm looking at content that we have, I divide it mainly to three. So it's like live, subscription-based, and ad-based. And so we are very much in the ad-based part of video today. We are looking to other places, but just to give some context. And if we're looking at video ad networks, because we're working also on the ad side, our platform touches all parts. Some platforms like the video ad networks, looking at video only from the ads side, we are looking also from the ads and the video. So we are here, we are the biggest, and if you're looking at Brightroll, which is a bit bigger in the unique viewers, but if you multiply it with the minutes viewed, minutes spent in each platform, you can see that we are much bigger. I don't like to say too much, we are big and et cetera, but I think it's important in order to understand the magnitude of what we have achieved. These are some of our content partners, and I'll reach to it in a minute. In the last 2 years, we started producing our own content as well. But our philosophy is that producing content usually has no ROI. And this was our perception from the beginning, that producing content is very pricey, and there's a lot of good content out there. So we decided to join hands with the content owners and distribute their content. So our premium video library, which contains now more than 800,000 videos, is built from a lot of content partners that we have and some content that we produce ourselves. So as I said, in the last 2 years, we started this thing that's called AOL on Originals, which is the tagline we chose for the last year and the 15 series that we produced is authentic voices and remarkable stories, because we think that the generation that we're looking into wants to see authentic and not like too, I won't say it. So let's just have a peek, I hope. As I said, producing content was a choice that we... Now it works, of course. It's a choice we took very late in the game, after we were already very big, and we thought that it is right to create some very premium content to be like the cherry on top of the cake. So I will present some things here. One of the first series that launched was Sharp Candidly Nicole. We chose Nicole Richie, which used to be, again, I won't say bad words, but, you know, a bit matured. She has 4 million Twitter followers, which is important for us, for the audience that we wanted to attract. It's a very nice, a very cute show, and it succeeded tremendously. I would also say that for us, the big success, we presented the slate, this is how we call it, of the 15 shows in March this year, in an event called the New Front, which is a parallel event for the upfronts of the TV industry, where they sell their content ahead to the advertisers. And there were many New Fronts events from YouTube, MSN, and other players, Yahoo. And just a few weeks ago, there was a big article by Mr. Shields, and he said that the New Fronts in the industry was a failure besides AOL's, because from the 15 shows that we showed, we sold 10 of those shows already, and some have yet to come. And when we were saying we sold them, we didn't sell only the ads on the shows themselves. For example, City Ballet by Sarah Jessica Parker was sold to Citibank together with part of the entertainment channel in our entire network. So it's like we're not selling only the show. Pretty much like in TV, when you want to buy something in, what's big now, in X Factor, you have to buy parts of ads in the Tochnit HaBoker. Or something like that. So that's the. So these are the numbers, which are big for series of that kind, and the social talk about it is also great. I won't go into too many details. I'll let you peek at Nicole Richie.
I'm alive, I'm alive, I'm alive. tramp stamp.
Okay.
I'm not that girl.
Nicole Richie, always candid, never afraid to go there in her AOL web series.
I'm so glad I don't live with you anymore.
I love you.
Gee, thanks.
The first episode of this had more than a million views, something like that.
It did.
Where
it
did this idea come from? How do people find it?
We decided, let's make little videos just based off of my, they call them my funniest tweets, I call them my stupidest tweets.
Never saw this video. other series says, and we won't get into details, Hardwired with iJustine, a YouTube star about wearable technology, Anthony Eats America, about food in America, and we have something in Italy about food as well, the Sartorialist. Already said, the largest premium content network, something that's coming with us already from the days of 5 Min is on every page, on every screen, and on every topic, which means that our platform works seamlessly on all devices, from connected devices to desktops. I'm going to talk a bit about branded entertainment, which is also an area that we went into. I have 3 minutes, so I'll just show the video about it. But it's big and it's fun.
Hello, mister. Pleased to meet you. Come take for a ride on a
just say while the video is running that we're making content for brands. We did an amazing video for Roma Football Club with Totti, which generated a lot of views, and the idea here is that we're not putting ads on top of those videos. The videos themselves, it's a different paying model, it's a CPV, and works beautifully, and it's the first sub-brand that we made global, and now we're going global with the whole platform. Other series that we did not produce but we were a part of, this is Acting Disruptive, is a series we have more series, and you can see all in AOL on .aol.com. And to summarize things, I think this is the last slide. What we want to do is not to replace TV and not to compete with it side by side. We believe that we have the positioning in the market to bridge the gap between them, to create a one whole experience of video viewing wherever you watch them, when you watch them, and how much you want to watch them. Thank you.